The next thing we're going to do in this module is derive the wave equations for the electric and magnetic fields from Maxwell's equations. Wave equations are differential equations that relate a quantity's second derivative in time to its second derivative in space. The solutions to these equations are waves, sinusoidal in both time and space. I like the familiar example of an ocean wave. So if you're standing in the water and measuring the depth of the water over time, an ocean wave will manifest as an approximately sinusoidal variation in observed depth. That's what it means for the wave to be sinusoidal in time. Alternatively, if you imagine pausing time and measuring the water depth as you move from the shore out toward the sea, you would see that same sinusoidal variation in depth. That's what it means for the wave to be sinusoidal in space. To derive the wave equation for the electric field, we can start with Faraday's law. Del cross E equals negative dB dt. If we take the curl of both sides of this equation, we get this. Del cross E equals negative the time derivative of del cross B. But since B equals mu H, and since del cross H is dd dt plus J by Ampere's law, we can rewrite this as del cross E equals negative mu times the double derivative of D with respect to time plus mu dj dt, or negative mu epsilon times the double time derivative of E minus mu dj dt. We can also simplify the left-hand side of the equation using this vector identity. So the del cross E becomes del of del dot E minus del squared E. And by Gauss's law, del dot E is equal to rho V over epsilon. So the final equation we obtain is this. The vector Laplacian of E, del squared E, equals mu times epsilon times the double time derivative of E plus mu dj dt plus the gradient of rho V over epsilon. In a source-free region, both the charge and the current go away, and we're left with this homogeneous wave equation for the electric field. Note that the vector Laplacian on the left is a second derivative in space, and this is related, by the wave equation, to a second derivative in time on the right. Similarly, we can derive a wave equation for the magnetic field, starting with Ampere's law. Again, the first step is to take the curl of both sides of the equation, which gives us del cross H equal to the time derivative of del cross D plus del cross J. But D, by the constitutive relation, is equal to epsilon E, and del cross E, by Faraday's law, is equal to negative dB dt. So now we have a double derivative in time on the right-hand side of the equation. We can apply the same vector identity as before to the left-hand side of the equation to get that del of del dot h minus the vector Laplacian of h equals negative mu epsilon d squared h dt squared plus del cross j. And finally, the solenoidal law says that this del dot h term is zero. So we're finally left with this wave equation for the magnetic field. In a source-free region, the current is zero, and the equation reduces to this. Again, the vector Laplacian on the left represents a second derivative in space, and it is related by this equation to a second derivative in time on the right. So what we've just shown is that in a source-free region, the electric and magnetic fields follow the wave equations shown here. These are also called the vector homogeneous Helmholtz equations. Note that the electric and magnetic fields both satisfy identical wave equations. These differential equations will also have identical solutions.